Namaste students, today we are going to start a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Inside Our Art.
Student, in this slide you can see about the art. The art, our homeland, is a dynamic planet. It is constantly undergoing changes and inside and outside. Slide, you can see our art is just like an onion. The art is made up of several concentric layers with one inside another. Next one, here you can see the picture of interior of the art. Next, here about the crust. The uppermost layer over the art surface is called crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. Next one is about the mantle. Just beneath the crust is the mantle, which extends up to a depth of 2900 kilometers below the crust. Next one is about the core. The innermost layer is the core, with a radius of about 3500 kilometers. It is mainly made up of nickel and iron, which is called the NIF. Ni means nickel and Fe means ferrous, that is iron. Next one is about the rocks and minerals. The art crust is made up of various types of rocks. Any natural mass of the mineral matter that makes up the art crust is called a rock. Rocks can be of different color, size and texture. Next is about types of rocks. There are three major types of rocks. They are igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and the last one, metamorphic rocks. In the next slide, you can see about the igneous rocks. When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. Rocks thus formed are called igneous rocks. They are also, you can also say it is as a primary rocks. We can divide igneous rocks into two types. First one is intrusive rocks and the second one is extrusive rocks. Next come the sedimentary rocks. Rocks roll down, then crack and hit each other and are broken down into small fragments. The small particles or the fragments are called the sediments. These sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, etc. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layers of rocks. These types of rocks are called sedimentary rocks. For example, we can say the sandstone is made from the grains of sand. These rocks may also contain fossils of the plants, animals and other microorganisms that once lived on them. Next, the metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks are formed from the igneous and the sedimentary rocks under great heat and the pressure. For example, clay changes into slate and the limestone into marble. The next one is about rock cycle. Rock cycle means the process of transformation of the rock from one to another under certain condition in a cyclic manner is known as the rock cycle. Here you can see the diagram how the rock cycle occurs. Next, you see, from the previous slide, you can see how the process of rock cycle occurs. The igneous rocks are broken down into small particles that are transported and deposited to form sedimentary rocks. When the igneous and the sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks, which are still under great heat and pressure, melt down to form molten magma. This molten magma again can cool down and solidify into igneous rock. थैंक यू।